We do want to bring you an update about the situation in India. It is far more desperate there. COVID cases are rising uncontrollably, with more than 400,000 reported on Friday. The virus also claiming another 3,500 lives. Those numbers, though, keep in mind, that's just the official count. The true death toll is likely much higher, as overwhelmed hospitals are actually having to turn people away.
Yeah, they're saying that the people who are dying at home aren't even being counted right now. Other countries are coming to India's aid, though. The first shipment from the U.S. arrived just as the Biden administration announced it's restricting travel from the country. Starting on Tuesday, only U.S. citizens and permanent residents will be allowed into the U.S. Travelers will still be required to show a negative COVID test or proof of vaccination upon arrival. In cities across India, though, there's this desperate search for oxygen specifically. I mean, look at these lines of people waiting for hours on the street just for a chance to breathe. Here's CNN's Sam Kiley.
A sensor reveals dangerously low levels of oxygen. Stifled by COVID-19, this canister of gas buys this patient time. All of these patients arrived barely able to breathe. This isn't a medical clinic, it's a tent on the outskirts of India's capital, run by volunteers.
Without the initiative being shown by these volunteers from the Hemkunt Foundation, who are providing oxygen on the street, on the outskirts of Delhi, they say many dozens, perhaps over 100 patients, would be in deep trouble medically now. They already had one death just over there earlier on today. They've treated over 100 people who've come in desperate for oxygen, unable to breathe. And it's all about this, the supply of these oxygen cylinders. It's a 300-mile drive each way to get one of these filled and brought back to Delhi.
They cost about $25 when filled.
How easy has it been to find oxygen?
Oh my God, trust me, this has been the toughest thing we are facing.
With COVID-19 infections and numbers of deaths breaking records daily in India, many patients in Delhi have given up on hospital treatment, where they know that oxygen is scarce and beds often shared. Pankaj Chandrawal said he was turned away by three hospitals. He took off his oxygen mask, demanding to be heard.
But they are just not entertaining anything, and they're just refusing all the things. I cannot tell to whom I can blame. It is both government and the hospitals also.
Bottled oxygen is mostly produced outside Delhi, and neighboring states are prioritizing their own needs. And so the city gasps, and many die unrecorded in their homes.
93A pocket I.
Jitinder Shunti collects the bodies of patients who die at home. He'll pick up three in this one-hour run. Many are even afraid to take their dying loved ones to hospital. Prashant Sharma's family decided to keep his grandmother at home.
We were scared seeing the condition around. So we got scared if we took her to any nearby hospital, who is going to, you know, be in touch with her? Who is going to give us the information, exact information, what is going on within the hospital?
India's government has promised a vaccination campaign with renewed vigor. But with around only 2% of the nation inoculated so far, that's cold comfort here.
Now I'm joining you from Batra Hospital, a very sharp contrast to what you just saw on the streets of Delhi. This is a sophisticated first world institution, some 500 beds, and it has been absolutely hammered. Just today, they lost eight people due to lack of oxygen in the space of a few hours. And I'm joined by the director of the hospital, Dr. S.C.L. Gupta. Doctor, how do you cope, and how on earth did this occur?
Is the most unfortunate situation today. Because of lack of oxygen, you are losing about 12 patients. The number is increasing. You are seeing them every day in the morning, and suddenly you see that he is no more. The person whom you could have saved the person who could have treated, and suddenly because of no oxygen, somebody is dying. This is absolutely not digestible.
Not digestible, and you've also, you lost a colleague today.
Yes. At the same time today, one of very senior person of my hospital, Dr. R.K. Himtani, who is the head of the Department of Gastroenterology. We lost such a wonderful person, and who was a real corona warrior. For the last 1 year, continuously he is fighting for corona patients. He got corona, he was admitted in ICU. One of my colleagues was saying that I was talking to him, and in front of me, he collapsed.
And these patients have all died today in the space of a few hours, I understand, because you even had to, you issued an appeal for oxygen and it just didn't come.
This is what happening for the last 1 week continuously and regularly. We are not getting the adequate supply of the oxygen in this my hospital, and not my hospital only. Most of the big hospitals in Delhi, they are not adequately supplied by oxygen. What a hospital wants from the Delhi government, they want oxygen. The amount which to be decided by as per the WHO parameters. And this amount as per your number of patients in the hospital. For example, in my patients.
I'm going to have to interrupt you there. So what we're seeing, though, Doctor, is effectively the demand and supply simply not being met. And earlier on, the doctor said to me that he was fighting a war against COVID, and oxygen was his aircraft carrier, his M16. It was the only weapon they had, and it's the only weapon they don't get given. Back to you.